Hello everyone, my name is Praveen and today I am going to teach you how to use ASP.NET Core MVC and connect to an existing database and read the data from this database or update, delete or create new data in this database. So that is the purpose of this video, and I am using Entity Framework Core 6 Visual Studio 2022 for this demo. So if you don't have it in your system, then please download it. You can find the links in the description of this video. Before we get started, also remember that I'll be using SQL Server. So you also need to get SQL Server Express and SQL Server Management Studio. So these are the two software which you should download if you want to run this or create this application in your system. So all these links will be in the description of this video. So let's get started. So create a new project using Visual Studio 2022. Go to the search here and search for ASP.NET MVC. So I am using MVC here, Model View Controller. So select this and hit the next button here, give a name. So let me give some name here. I'll say it country app because I'll be using a database table which will contain a list of countries. So I'm just giving this name country app. So next, I'll be using .NET 6.0. So this is fine, the default one. Click create. The next step is actually to create the database. Okay, which to save time, I have actually created the database, but I will let you know what to do here. So if you have already installed Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio, then open it, go to File, Connect, and then connect to your local SQL Express server. So that is the one which is created when you install SQL Express. So and then hit Connect, and then it will open up in your left pane like this. So expand it. So here you can see a database called as Human Resource, which I have created. So in this, for simplicity, I have just one table called as Country. So you can create this database. To create it, just right click, New Database, and then give the database any name and click on OK. So this database will be created. And once it is created, expand it, go here to Tables, right click, New, and select Table. So you will get a window like this where you can enter the column names and all the fields in that table. So let's go to this table which I have already created. So here go to design, and then you can see all these columns in this table. Okay, so here you can see that I have a primary key which is ID. So to so you can create this all these columns and then right click this and then make it as primary key. So here it is coming as remove primary key because I have already made it primary key, but otherwise you will have this option to create the primary key here to make it a primary key. So do that. And also this is an identity column, which means it will be created. So the values in this column will be inserted automatically whenever I insert a new record. So no need for me to explicitly insert a value in this particular column. So for that, just select the column, and here you can see this is identity. So go here and select yes. So by default it will be no, so you have to select make it yes, and once you do it, it will become an identity column, and then you make it primary key, and then you add all other columns like this and the data types as shown. Once it is done, you can go right click and edit the rows. So here you can see I have already added some country names, but if you edit it, so automatically you can actually, this column will automatically increment. As I said before, now in the name you can actually add the country names. For example, I will add one country to show you how it is done. So Tokyo population, so let's say it is in millions. I don't know exactly what is the population of Japan, but so I am just giving some dummy values here. Economy, so 5, and Japan's currency is yen. And then just select any other field and this will be updated. Okay, so once it is updated, so we can close this. So we have all the records now in the database table. So let's come out of this and go to our .NET project. So in our .NET project, we have to actually add some packages, NuGet packages. So right click, manage NuGet packages, browse, and here, yes, so this one is one package, SQL Server, install it, accept, finish. Then the other one is tools, install that also. And then install one more that is called as configuration. So this one, microsoft.extensions.configuration, so that you can read the app settings. Install this. So now we should have all the packages. So you can see that these are the packages we have installed. Let's close this. Okay, save, close. Now the next step is to create, we already have a models folder. So the next step will be to scaffold, basically to create all the models and DBcontext class. So for that, we have to type one command. So that command, we have to go to this tools, NuGet package manager, package manager console. We have to type it here. So the command is scaffold. DBcontext. Server equal to dot slash dot is basically dot slash means it will go to your local. You can also type your machine name slash SQL Express, or if it is installed, if your SQL Express is in another machine, then you can give that name as well. So give that path. Now database equal to human resource, semicolon, trusted connections, trusted underscore connection is true, and then semicolon. After that, Microsoft dot entity framework core. Dot SQL Server hyphen. So where do we want our classes to be, all those objects or classes to be created? So that is our output directory. So output dir models. So that is the command. I hope I have typed it correctly. Let's see. Build started, build succeeded. So yeah, so this warning is fine. So now it looks like all the objects are created. You can see this context object has been created. So inside models folder, you can also see the country entity has been created and the database context object has been created. Okay, so here it is saying that we should not have this connection string here in the code. Rather, it should be configurable. So what we will do is we will go to the app settings and we will create it there. Okay, so go to the app settings and then type and create this. Create this connection strings. Let's give a name DB one. This is the same. I can copy it from here. So the connection string is fine. So this is the additional one. Create it. So now the connection string is created, and we can delete this. We don't actually need this line here. Rather, what we should do is we should go to the program.cs and add a line here. I will add it here, builder.services.addbcontext. So the type here is human. Okay, I have to actually copy some namespaces here. Using soft dot entity framework core, and also models. Okay, country app dot models. Now come back here and then type human resource context and then bracket options. Dot use SQL server, and within it, so you can hit enter, bring it to the second line. Within this builder dot configuration dot get connection string, and dbcon close it with a semicolon. So now you have this. So we have now added the DBcontext to the builder as a middleware. So which means it knows where to go and get the connection string and read the data from there. So now we have told the application that this is the location. So once this is done, so you have the connection string here. We are reading it here, and we have the context class ready. So right click on the controllers folder, add, and go to new scaffolded item. So here you can see MVC controller with views using entity framework. So select this, click on add button, model class. So ours is country, select country, data context class, human resource context. So actually things is okay. Click on add. Okay, so the scaffolding is complete, and we have all these methods inside the controller. So this controller has been created, countries controller, and you can see all these action methods added within it. So the next step is to point to this controller so that we can run the application. So for that, go to views, shared layout, and here add one more link. So let's copy this, paste it here, and say country, and here we can give the name as of this controller, which is countries. Actually the name can also be countries. So this link will be created now. Let's close it and build it. We'll succeed it, run it. Okay, so the home page has opened up. Click on countries. Now you can see all the countries being retrieved. So this is the retrieval part where you are able to, this application is able to read all the data from our database and show it here. So let's try to edit the data. So click on this edit button. So you can see this page has opened up. So let's make it 32. So here you can see the 32 number has been reflected back. So let's see if the details is fine. For details, you can see the details of that country. So which is also 32. So everything is created properly. So like this, we can go and we can change other countries also. Let me go to India. And here, let's make it 4 instead of 3. So now you can see India also is 4. So let's now test the delete functionality. So let's delete Japan. Okay, so it is asking whether you want to, it is confirming from me. So yes, delete. And now Japan is gone from the list. Let's create a new one. So Ireland capital, Dublin nation. Army parents. So let's create it. Yeah, now we can see Ireland is also created here. So so that's the CRUD operation, create, read, update and delete. Hope you like this video today, and if you want to get more such updates, then please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon, and do not forget to like this video. Thanks a lot for watching.